Hey designers, in today's tutorial, you're going to learn how to create this flat illustration and then add some grain texture to it using Illustrator. We're gonna start with a simple sketch, then we're going to move and trace it and add some texture using a grain brush. Inside Illustrator, let's hit create new document. I'm going to use a very basic one, a web document. Let's name it tutorial and hit create. Let's place the exercise files by clicking and dragging. You can find exercise files in the description of this video, and that should help you get started. I'm going to sample these colors just to have a basic color scheme set up, and then remove that image once we are done with it. Let's go to view, snap to pixel, disable it because I don't like the way it works when it's enabled. And once you have the sketch selected, lower its opacity, and in the layers panel, go ahead and lock this layer up so you won't accidentally hit it. Create a new layer, have it beneath the sketch, and once you have it selected, you can start adding shapes using the pen tool. Let's reverse the color so we only have an outline, and click and drag to create anchor points and try to trace it as close as possible. I'm only trying to have one half of the gamepad, because the other half I'm just going to duplicate and merge those elements together. I'm doing the same things for the side elements as well. And for the D-pad, I'm going to use the rectangle tool. Just click and drag, and once you have one part of it, copy and paste in front and rotate it around 90 degrees to create the D-pad. I'm going to also use the mirror feature. Select that element, hit a point in the middle, and holding down the Alt key, you're going to make it duplicate. Now we already have these elements, so let's move to the crown. The crown, pretty much the same thing. As you can see, it has very simple elements. Holding down the Alt key and having the mirror feature, you can make a duplicate of those elements. We're going to use the Shape Builder tool to merge things together. Make sure they're selected and click and drag to add. And holding down the Alt key, you can subtract. I've now added the orange color to the fill, and we also need a background color. So let's create a rectangle, send it to the back, add the color from the swatches panel. In the layers tab, we need to open this up because we're going to lock this layer up and also disable the sketch because we don't need it anymore. It's time to add some color to the illustration, and let's assign different colors. Let's do white for the middle element and black for the side ones. To send them back, you can use this command. And once you have done that, I'm going to do a small, changes with the direct selection tool. I'm just going to make the illustration a bit more irregular looking. This is, in my opinion, where the fun part starts, adding the actual grain texture. With the shape selected, click on drawing modes and select the drawing side option, which means that any brush stroke or texture you're going to add will only be visible inside that shape. Think of it like a clipping mask. The first step is to create a path and then apply a brush on that path. I'm using my grain brush selection called Arcadia, which you can find in the description of this video. We'll apply a color to the brush stroke, and I'll go for the same green as the background. This will make it more visible, and now I can cycle through the options to find out which one looks the best for this simple illustration. I think I'm going with the fourth option, and do some adjustments to the position of the path to have a smooth transition between colors. You can also continue the path that has the grain added and apply it on other parts of the shape as well. For the white shape, you can create a path all around it while you have the drawing side mode activated and apply a brush to that path. I'm sticking to the green because I want it to blend in with the background. And you can also move anchors around till you find the look that you're happy with. And remember that when you are creating paths, you can also use the paintbrush tool and draw on top of elements where you'd like for the grain to appear. With flat design illustrations, I would always recommend using a very simple color scheme and stick to that unless you want to create some more complex shading. For the bottom element of the crown, you can shade it from the sides. And with the actual crown, I recommend creating a curved path using the pen tool. Start from the left hand side and try to imagine how it will look before even applying the brush. Right now, it's a bit too much, so double click to enter the mask and move the grain a bit down. For the top elements of the crown, you can use a semicircle and shade them from the sides. Maybe except for the center one, for which you can place the shadow on the bottom of the shape. As we move closer to the end of this tutorial, I suggest taking the paintbrush tool and adding points of texture wherever you feel the illustration needs it. You can add it for any element that should glow, or if you'd like to add some depth by creating shadows, add them underneath the shape. I made a duplicate of the semicircle and just made the adjustments to have it work as a shadow for the center element as well. Hit command left bracket a couple of times, and now it's time to add the texture overlay on the whole document. From the exercise files, click and drag the texture example file to Illustrator, then copy those paths, move back to the illustration canvas and paste it on top. I think this brings the whole canvas a bit to life, but would also like to have white particles as well, so I'll make a copy, rotate it around and apply a white fill. This is the final look with the grain texture applied. If you like this Illustrator tutorial and the steps we've taken to get here, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more. Remember that you can download the free grain brush and the exercise files from the link in the description. If you want to take your illustrations to the next level though, I've just released a premium pack of brushes called Arcadia. Check the description for a special discount code for the first 100 designers that access it. See you in the next video.